Hello, Mr. R. Mitchell, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Jesus was the first anointed Christ who came into this world, and he was the first light of the dark age. Two prophets came in the Middle East, John the Baptist, an ideal rabbi, our prophet Elijah, and Christ Jesus. John the Baptist paved the way, and Christ Jesus then preached the gospel to the sons of Abraham. John the Baptist made the Jewish men of age, sensible one, the sons of Abraham, and he baptized them in the name of Abraham. Not in the name of Holy Son, Father, and all that. That is messianic corruption. And you should be aware of them. So, Jesus also prepared 70 outer circle laborers, which were the ideal rabbis in the name of John the Baptist, so that they can pave the way for the 12 apostles who came in the name of Jesus. They preached gospel while the 70 prepared the people morally sound, baptizing them in the name of Abraham, making them sons of man or sons of Abraham to be turned into sons of God by the 12 apostles. Of course, they were later on was added other preachers like Saul. He was turned into Paul, and he was a Christ Paul. He did the same job as Christ Jesus. So, end of the world could be right according to the Mayan calendar. Many have heard of this Mayan calendar, which applies to the spiritual word of Christ, when everyone is to give his own account to God. In Jesus, you know, these dark-colored people, these robed fathers and other people, they can't give your account to God. You have to give your account yourself. So they are anti-Christ, and they fulfill Matthew 12, 43 to 45, the arid spirit, you know, the temple priest, when they were sacked by destroying the temple, they could not find green pasture. So they entered into the church of God, and then they corrupted the whole thing and set up their shop there. It is the golden age when everyone is set free, but not many take advantage of this freedom that Christ Jesus earned for us by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. Remember when John the Baptist baptized men in the name of Abraham, then he sent them to, hey, here is the Lamb of the God coming. Listen to him. Most of his predictions have been fulfilled. The destruction of temple forever, that was destroyed in 70 AD. 70 is the number of the Sanhedrin members. So, the coming of the second anointed Christ, it was Satguru Nanak Dev Ji of India, Punjab, who came in 1469. So that has been fulfilled too. Now the end of the world is coming, and bundling of the tares in Israel for final burning, Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30, is taking place. These chosen people, they are special people, demonstration nation of the world. Whenever they are faithful to Abraham, they live in peace and prosperity in the promised land. But whenever they become unfaithful, the same land becomes barren and they have to leave. Last time, Moses brought them back from Egypt, And this story is told in the parable of the prodigal son. The younger one was Isaac. The elder was Ishmael, and father is Abraham. So, for Israel final burning, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, when the atomic war will end this age, bringing in the new age called SATTYUG of Saints. They will be SATTYUG people after this atomic war. They will be all in God, God be in them. They are living in the company of God, as is stated. This Middle East unrest is created by the sons of Satan, not knowing that you can tell lies to men, but not to our Father God, called Allah in Arabic. So people, you know, they do wrong things, you know. They think we can make fool of the people and get away with it. For example, the Iraq war, you know, there was no weapons of mass destruction, but they destroyed the country as he was threatening Israel with the gun. So what is happening is according to the will of our Father. And our job is to fish men. Spiritual men are those people who are masters of their own destiny. Like in John 9, the born blind person. He was master of his own destiny. Such are the men we want to fish into the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is within your heart, whereas the kingdom of heaven is outside in law and order. Many people don't know the difference between the two. Women, you know, in spiritual language, women are those people, you know, who just follow others. They are not masters of their own destiny. Cannot be fished into the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is for the solitary people, and people who are masters of their own destiny, they are solitary. The other just follow the organized religions, or you can call it sects, like these Baptist, Methodist, Church of England. All these are Antichrist sects. And people, when they follow these wide road, which lead to the hell, sectarian rites, then they suffer, you know. People who are in God, they are always solitary. They don't attach themselves with these organized churches. And they enjoy the fruit of His word. So, Mayan calendar is spiritual as it goes negative, which is just the opposite of our physical age. What applied to flesh, the opposite applied to spirit as you know it. So this calendar applies to spirit. That means when we come into this world, we come with certain number of years to live. And as our physical age goes up, our spiritual age goes down, the other way around. And when our spiritual age touches zero, then we die. So is this calendar. When it touches zero, we expect the end of age, in which people who do not forget their tribal links would be saved. That Jesus has stated, every plant that my heavenly Father did not plant, my heavenly Father is Yahweh, the creator of male and female. Our Father God is not the creator of male and female. Our Father is spirit and not this creator of fleshes. So did not plant shall be uprooted. Those who forget their tribal identity or who become sons of Satan, they will be killed. The same has been stressed by the second anointed Christ, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji of India. And so what's happening and you are watching now is the end of the world, which is expected according to the Mayan calendar around 23rd, 24th December 2012. By the speed the things are happening in this world, you can see now, and we can expect this Mayan calendar to be true, but our Father knows the exact time when that will happen. But we being, our wisdom being foolish to our Father, we just guess that this could be true. So let's see what happens and keep it in mind that this is the golden age for you to earn your salvation by preaching gospel. This Christ Jesus said when it fed the 5,000 people with heavenly bread, which was very tasty, they loved it. Then Christ Jesus started preaching gospel. Unless you eat the flesh of Jesus. Eating the flesh of Jesus means what comes out of the mouth of Jesus. You understand it, the gospel truth which he has spoken, and drink the blood of Christ. You drink the blood of Christ when you have Christ in your heart and you preach gospel. Christ cannot rest in your heart if your heart is dirty or mammon worshipper. If you love mammon more than God, then the gospel cannot rest. There are many people, you know, who do favors to others just to please them as politicians do. Their hearts are not righteous. They are unrighteous people. So they would not love his word, or they won't love Christ to come into their heart or into their life. They are hypocrite. So you need to be sincere to have Christ in your heart, and that sincerity is be righteous, because in Jesus sins have no value. We are no more slaves to the sins but to the righteousness, and it is by the grace of our Father that you will know the gospel. No grace, no gospel, no Christ in your heart. Our Father God blesses you.